name is Andi Dayton. I'm 24 years old, and I'm from Hazard, Kentucky.
Who have you brought with you today?
My mom, Vicky, my godmother, Lissa, my sister, Holly, my maid of honor, Brianna, and my fiancé, Colby.
Uh-oh.
I did bring the fiancé. I'm very untraditional, so I brought him with me. Colby and I met about 6 years ago. We do a lot of adventurous things together. We've been to Ireland and Mexico, go skiing once a year. We own 2 Harley Davidsons. We're just adventurous people.
Where are you getting married?
In St. Thomas.
Okay.
On a sailboat. Right, that changes things a little bit. I've got to be able to step up on the boat itself, right. So I'm gonna need something kind of loose.
All right, that makes sense.
Something form-fitting more at the top, a little bit flowy toward the bottom.
You're pretty much on the same page.
No.
I would like to see her in a short dress.
I want something different. I want something off the wall. I just don't want the same old dress.
Ultimately, this dress is for him, but I have to like it too. I don't want a short dress. A short dress is not very bridal. Short dresses to me are party dresses. The rehearsal dinner, the reception later, but not the ceremony.
So you're a little more traditional.
That's the only aspect I'm a little bit traditional about.
Okay. Brings me to budget.
My budget is $2,000.
Great. I think we're ready to get started.
Let's go.
Even the most non-traditional girls still want to feel like a bride for their wedding day.
That is cute.
Flowers and lace.
Ooh, that's pretty.
Tulle and poofy skirts.
Ooh, this is a pretty dress.
It's like it's in a girl's DNA. We just can't resist.
Oh, jeez.
Boys, however.
I don't like the flowers.
They're missing that gene.
Just not struck on lace.
Crap!
I feel I need to stand my ground because I'm non-traditional and I have to look at it too.
We've got short dresses right here.
Oh, no.
I like the feathers on it. I think they look a little different.
Colby's killing me with this dress. He is totally off the chart.
Hoping to please the bride first, consultant Melissa puts bride Andi in her own more traditional pick, a long lace sheath gown.
Excited about this one.
This is pretty. This dress is very beautiful. It's good on my figure. It might be a real contender.
Like this.
I love the fit here, and I love the train.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like that. Very bridal looking.
Colby?
It is traditional. That's why I don't care much for it. Just looks plain. I mean, it just don't have a kick. Nothing traditional. That's what we want.
But then she won't really look like a bride.
This is the single most important garment I will ever wear.
Yeah.
And swim in.
What's that mean?
I will be trashing the dress.
You don't do what? You've got to be me. And what if one day your daughter says, Mom, I want to wear your wedding gown, and it shrunk up about this big? What are you going
to
do then?
Well, I'm going to say, honey, we'll take you on down to Bridals by Lori. We'll get you another dress.
Honey, I'm not going to argue with that. But this is going to be like putting 2 anchors on your ankles and going straight down. I mean, I'd be worried about your safety.
It does feel a little heavy.
Okay, let's go find a dress that you feel bridal in that you can trash, honey.
So consultant Melissa puts bride Andi in her fiancé's lightweight pick next, an ivory silk cocktail gown with a feather skirt.
I feel like a big old chicken in this dress. Look like something that should be flying around the sailboat, not on the sailboat getting married.
We'll show it to him.
Okay.
This was his pick.
Ooh, somebody got the evil eye, Colby. Tell us what you think.
I feel like I've been plucked from here to here.
What do you think about it, Colby?
Oh, this would be a wonderful dress to trash. I really like the feathers. She won't sink to the bottom. She'll float.
This dress probably does need to be trashed, maybe today. It's not the dress. To me, a short dress is not a wedding dress.
I want a long dress. And that's not what Colby wants.
All right, let's try another one then. Colby's only thinking about the dress after she jumps in the water, but Andi wants to look like a bride on dry land. I've got a crazy idea, which might just be perfect for these two.
Lori's pick is an ivory lace gown with a full tulle skirt.
Oh my, this dress feels so bright. It's got lace, it's got the full skirt. I'd feel like a bride in this dress. And guess what?
Voila!
You can tear it away, and it's a short dress.
Oh, wow. This ups it a little bit. I like this.
I love this dress. It's just so beautiful, and it's just perfect for my destination wedding.
This might be a winner.
I'm not much on it. I'm still stuck on the short dresses.
I want him to be happy with my choice, but Colby has taken this non-traditional thing to a whole nother level.
They might have thrown me for a loop about trash in the dress, but payback is a you-know-what. Now I have a surprise for Colby.
This is on the boat with the tulle blowing in the breeze. So then we get ready to jump off the boat.
Woo!
And it's a short dress.
Mm-hmm. And it still looks bridal, don't y'all agree?
It's the best of both worlds.
What do you think, Cope?
She's gorgeous.
I love that dress. She'll be a gorgeous bride, and she'll be stunning.
Okay, now, Colby has seen the dress. Colby loves the dress. Do you want Colby to see, like, the whole finished product?
I don't think so.
Okay, bye, Colby.
Love you, bud.
Thanks for playing with us, Colby.
I really wanted to see the veil, but it's all about anticipation now. Can't wait till that day.
Oh, that's very nice.
I love the veil. I love the belt. This dress is fabulous.
So you're saying what to this dress?
I'm saying yes to this dress.
Yay! This dress, it's just so beautiful and it's so perfect. We'll see. I'm a little torn. I don't know if I'll take the plunge or not.